I was at the age of maybe 10 or 12, and like the kids playing in the yard, my parents would say,
don't go near MCV on the other side of the viaduct.
The student doctors from the hospital comes around and get you and put you in some kind of wagon or something because you have MCV and experiment on your body.
One other incident that I heard, somebody had come up missing, a black woman, and nobody never investigated to find out what had happened to her. But it was assumed that one of the student doctors at MCV had got her.
It was just like a saying or like just a general warning of the old folks, you know, in that area, hey, at nighttime, you know, you don't go across the viaduct bridge.
Non-native Richmonders, when hearing these stories, might at first be inclined to dismiss them as mere folklore. However, in 1996, an archaeological discovery of human remains at the Medical College of Virginia provided evidence that the accounts given by these native Richmonders were grounded in a historical reality.
I was asked to go down and look at some possible archaeological remains at MCV next to the Egyptian building where some construction was going on for a new facility for the medical college. There was an old well there, and the well was essentially filled with various kinds of artifacts, but primarily human bones. It was pretty obvious to me that we were looking at a mid-19th century repository of cadaver remains. Later on, we had most of the human remains at least studied briefly by forensic anthropologists at the Smithsonian Institution, and the report came back that they were virtually all those of African American people.
So folklore becomes truth. The human remains found in the well outside of the Medical College of Virginia shed light on the existence of an industry that once flourished in Richmond, the trade in human cadavers for medical dissection. And the person responsible for this well, for the acquisition, keeping, and disposal of the human remains used in this way, was a black Richmonder named Chris Baker.
Chris Baker was the anatomical attendant at the Medical College of Virginia from some point probably in the 1870s until he died in 1919. And it was his job to prepare the cadavers for the students to dissect, as well as to bring out anatomical specimens to either the demonstrator of anatomy or the professor of anatomy. Chris Baker received payment, as did other individuals who the college hired over the years to procure bodies. Of course, at this time it was illegal to procure these bodies. We are aware, because he was subsequently arrested in the 1880s, that he did in fact go out on raids himself.
Historically, grave robbing has been of two kinds. Both were for profit, but when this profit became a part of the chain of justifications for sacrificing black bodies to the higher aims of science, a truly perverse ego of entitlement was created in the practitioners of medicine.
Medical College of Virginia catalog, they would brag that they had clinical material, dissecting material, readily available in the city of Richmond, so that students would be attracted to come there because they knew that they could do dissection, that bodies were there.
Medical dissection is customary. Today, all or nearly all medical students have to dissect a human cadaver. It's, in a way, a kind of rite of passage as it's developed over time, but it's also an essential way to understand the inner workings of the human body.
You in the hospital, you the doctor, and where you got your prestige was how many cadavers you had been into. That determined, it's like, how many home runs did you hit? Well, cadavers was to medicine what home runs is to baseball.
There was clearly a racial disparity in the procurement of human cadavers for use in the anatomical labs of medical colleges in the United States. Given the widespread belief in the inferiority of African descent people, including physical differences between blacks and whites that were believed to exist, why would grave robbers target African American cemeteries to feed the trade in human cadavers?
That's the $64,000 question. Why were all of these cadavers studied by these students black?
louder.